Hi, folks. Welcome to today's contest for the Reading Rocket D Squad in their home opener here at Hollingsworth Field. It's Sunday, September 20th. It's a beautiful day. It's going to be a nice day for football, probably in the low 70s with partly cloudy sunshine. Your captains for today are number 10, Eamon Santrella, and number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis. And we'll wait to see what happens here with the coin toss as the Rockets versus Westford. It's the Rockets versus Westford. And the toss. And it looks like, I'm not sure what happened here. Let's see. It looks like Reading has won the toss. And waiting to get a signal here. Looks like they've deferred. Seems to be maybe a little confusion on the sidelines here, but I'm sure these coaches will get it all straightened out. And it looks like, yeah, okay. So the Reading Rockets have deferred. Westford will receive the kickoff. As we'll come back to you here momentarily for kickoff action, Reading versus Westford. Go ahead, go. All right, number 6, Giacomo Iapica will be kicking off for the Rockets from his own 40-yard line. Ball game is underway. The kick is up, and Westford will receive. He's got a little bit of makes a move on the outside. Oh, he's still on his feet. He's running. He's got a nice return off of that kickoff, probably about a 10-yard return. The Rockets will go on defense as the Westford comes out first and 10 from their own 49.
Ready?
First and 10 for Westford as they come to the line of scrimmage. They're at their own 49-yard line. The Rockets in their standard, looks like 5-3 defense. It's the handoff, right side. He's in pursuit by Brendan Nowicki. Finally pushed out of bounds by Nowicki and Iapica for a gain of about 5 yards on the play, bringing up second down. Second down, 5 yards to go. Westford comes up to the line of scrimmage. Quarterback gives the motion, gives a signal, the man in motion. It's fake handoff. Looks like a trap play, but oh, Colin Donahue is there to say, oh, no way. Great play by Donahue to skip into the backfield, stop the running back for probably about a yard loss on the play, bringing up third down. Good. All right, big third down here for the Reading D. Let's see if they can hold them. Third down, 8 yards to go. Westford's at the Rocket 49. There's the snap, the handoff to number 10. Donahue again in the backfield to get his hand on him. What a play. He's finally wrapped up by, looks like, yep, it was number 80, Dylan Sweetser there on the play to come in and stop him behind the line. So Westford getting knocked back to the original line of scrimmage, bringing up fourth down. Fourth down, 10 yards to go. Westford's back inside their own territory. Let's see what they're going to go for it. Got a man in motion. Is the QB keep. He's looking for room on the outside. Nowicki's there. He's finally almost wrapped up. Number 51. Oh, and he stays on his feet. Finally brought down by number 10, Eamon Santrella. But the Westford was able to, great running there by the quarterback. He was able to basically make something out of nothing as he scrambled for a first down, bringing the Westford football team here down to the Rocket 30-yard line, first and 10. First down, 10 yards to go. Westford's marching. They're on the Rocket 30-yard line. It's the quarterback. He's the little trap play, off tackle. Met nicely at the line of scrimmage for no gain by number 10, Eamon Santrella, and number 50, Jason Anderson, bringing up second down. All right, Westford marches up to the line of scrimmage. Second down. It's the give. It's a little trap play behind the line of scrimmage. But Reading is not fooled as they're in position to make the stop. He did get about a yard or two, but Giacomo Iapica Braden Nowicki, Eamon Santrella, and looks like Jack Janes were in there to make the play, stop him for about a 3 yard gain. All right, here we go. Another big third down for the Reading Rock D squad. They got, Westford has a man in motion. It's quarterback. He's going to try to keep it himself. He does have a little room outside as he was able to get a first down on it. He found a hole to the left side of his line, and he took advantage of it, scrambling for a first down about 8 yards as Westford moves the chains. First down. Westford comes to the line of scrimmage. They have a first down, 10 yards to go. They're at the Rocket 22-yard line. There's the snap. The give is to the wingback coming across behind the line. Nice little trap play. He moves the down marker a little bit, probably about a 3 yard gain on that before he's wrapped up by a host of Reading Rocket defenders. It's going to be second down. All right. Rockets are being tested here inside the red zone. Second down. About 6 yards to go for Westford. There's the snap. The handoff. The ball's on the ground. Oh, it looks like Redding jumped on it. We'll wait for a coach for a umpire decision here. And no, it looks geez, I thought the Rockets had it there. It was hard to see who jumped on that ball for Reading, but nonetheless, Westford is able to keep the ball, retain possession, knock them back about a yard, but it's going to be third and nine. And as they line up to the line of scrimmage, quarterback gives the signals. There's the snap, little trap play. He's going to try to fake play. He's going to try to keep it himself. He plows ahead. It's going to be short of the first down. Nice little run. But we're going to bring up, he's going to be short. Fourth down. All right, Redding's going to be tested here for the second time on fourth. Tested for the second time of the game on fourth down. Fourth down, 4 yards to go for Westford. There's the quarterback keep. He's going to try to, Donahue is there to make the play. What an excellent play by Colin Donahue to get in there, get his arm off him, get his arm on the running back, stop him short of the first down. Giving Reading a change of possession. First down for the Reading Rockets. Okay, Reading's going to take over on downs. They've got the ball first and 10. They're at their own 18-yard line. They've got first possession here on offense. Centrella gives off. Handed it to... It's hard to see who got the handoff on that. Looks like number seven, Brendan Lindmark, scampered through the hole for a nice little run there of about 5 yards, 6 yards, bringing up second down. The Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Looks like Santrella is under center. Second down, the handoff once again. They're trying to push ahead. Little off-tackle play there. Let's see who was on the ball carry. It looks like maybe number seven again, Brendan Lindmark, for about a two-yard rush, bringing up third down, 2 yards to go. Big play. Let's see how they come out of this one here. Third down, 2 yards to go. They're at their own 21-yard line. They're in the power eye formation. It's the pitch pass. The pitch is to Lindmark, but he's unfortunately met behind the line of scrimmage. Nowhere to go. Loss on the play. It's going to bring up a big fourth down for the Reading Rockets. And it looks like they're going to bring in their punt squad. Yeah, they're going to punt on this. Good decision, coaches. Let's get that ball back there and see what we can do. Okay, that brings up the end of the first period. And at this, or the first quarter rather, at this time we're going to do our first player profile of the game. And we're going to be looking at this. This time we're going to be looking at number 81, Zachary Galvin. Number 81, Zachary Galvin. Zachary is a fifth grader. He's at the Joshua Eaton School. His favorite food is barbecue ribs, one of my favorite as well. When he's not playing football, he enjoys reading. And when he's all grown up, he wants to be a veterinarian. So that's number 81, Zachary Galvin. Fourth down for the Reading Rockets. Number 70, Brady Swanson, checks into the game. Looks like he's going to be the long snapper on this. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica is back to kick. See if he can get a good boot under this one. Great snap. There's the kick. Decent kick. And caught by Westford. Yeah, so nice play by the Westford return man. Catches it on the 30-yard line. So it's going to be first and 10 for Westford as they'll be on the Rocket 30-yard line. Westford marches up to the line of scrimmage. They are in what looks to be like a wishbone formation. And we've got timeout on the field. Timeout Reading, I believe. Okay, first down, 10 yards to go. Looks like everybody's squared away. Westford gets the ball, gives it to the running back who's got a little room outside. He's being chased by number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, finally brought down with combination. Looked to be Beckenhuis and Carter Leonard on the play. Westford gains about 3 yards, second down. Second down, 5 yards to go. Number 50, Jason Anderson. And number 51, Ryan Bonacci are playing your tackles for now. It's a handoff. Uh-oh, Westford running back's got some room. He found a hole, he's chugging ahead. And he gets that was a nice run by Westford. He's finally brought down at about looks like the 1 yard line. Looks like number 81, Zachary Galvin, was in on the tackle to save the touchdown. First and goal, Westford. First down, 1 yard to go for Westford. The Westford Junior Ghosts, by the way, is the snap. He's trying to plow ahead. Let's see if this is, and there is. There's a signal from the referees. It's a touchdown. 6 points for Westford as they go off tackle and cross the goal line. 6-0, Westford. Okay, Westford comes up to the line of scrimmage for the extra try. They are going to go for it. Split backfield. He's going to roll out and try to pass. And wow, what a play by Westford. Got to give him credit on that. The quarterback got it, rolled out, and the receiver made a diving catch for the extra point. So with about 8 minutes left in the ball game, we have Reading 0, Westford Junior Ghosts 7. Okay, Westford's going to kick up ball. The Westford Junior Ghost, the ghost came in and knocked the ball off the tee. But looks like Westford's got it squared away as they're prepared to kick off. Back deep is number 7, Brendan Lindmark. Number 3, Braden Nowicki. It's a kick. It's a bouncing kick. And it's going to go out of bounds. That's a penalty on the play. As Westford kicked it short, kicked it out of bounds. And Reading will get a few extra yards out of that. So it'll be first and 10, Reading. Okay, so as Reading gets ready to take over on downs. They have the ball at their own 47, at Westford's 47-yard line. The line right now consists of number 70, Brady Swanson. Number 50, Jason Anderson. Your quarterback is number 10, Eamon Santrella. And he's under center. He's going to give it. The give is to to be like number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis. It was. He's able to march forward for a couple yards. On that line as well would be number 6, Ron Iapica. Number 80, Dylan Sweetser. number 72, Sean Murphy. And number, looks like number 40, Jack Jane. So it'll be second down, 8 yards to go. Redding comes up to the line of scrimmage. Power eye backfield. And there's the give. It's to the fullback, number 6, Ron Iapicki. He's trying to get some room. He does. He gets about a yard out of there, about a yard on the run. It's going to bring up third down, 6 yards to go. Big third down here for the Rockets as they're on the Westford 44-yard line. They've got about a long seven yards to go for that first down. There's the snap. Centrella's going to pitch it out. He's got Beckenhuis. Beckenhuis is plowing ahead. But just enough, unfortunately, to get back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe a half a yard out of that rush. It's going to bring up fourth down for the Rockets. Fourth down. All right, a big fourth down here for the Rockets. Fourth and 6. Again, a long 6. They're at their own 43-yard line. They're at the Westford 43-yard line. Excuse me. Shotgun position for quarterback. Centrella's going to he's looking for the pass. No, he's going to tuck it, keep it himself. He's trying to get some room. Unfortunately, stopped behind the line of scrimmage for no gain. And it's going to be a turnover as Westford goes on offense. So for our second player profile, we'd like to look at number 72, Sean Murphy. Sean Murphy's nickname is Gook. Cool nickname. He's a fifth grader over at the Birch Meadow Elementary School. His favorite food is steak. His favorite superhero is Flash Gordon. And when he's not playing football, he enjoys reading. And when he grows up, he wants to be a scientist. So that's number 72, Sean Murphy. So as Redding comes out, they're on defense. Right now, we'll look at this defensive squad here for the Rockets, who've got number 71, Colin Donahue, on the line. And we'll come back to that after the play. Man in motion for Westford. It's a quarterback keep. And, oh, what a play. It looked like number 50, Jason Anderson, got into the play to stop him, to allow for the other Rocket defenders to get there. Nice play by the Rockets. Second down and 10. Number 22, Jordan Whitmer, checks in. Looks like he's playing your left tackle. See if he can make a difference here on this play. And there's the snap. It's a reverse, but not fooled is number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, saying, no, sir. Great play. Great play by Beckenhuis and the Rockets. Sniff that up, bringing a third down, 10 yards to go. Okay, number 41, Sean Crowley, checked in, also playing the line. Let's see if he can make a difference here as well. So far, that defense is doing it. It's a quarterback keeper. He's trying to get around the outside. He's being pursued by number 3, Braden Nowicki, and the Rocket defense comes up big here, pulling up a fourth down for the Junior Ghosts. Fourth down and about 8 yards to go as we've got a timeout on the field. Timeout. Okay, number 20, Noah Roach. Number 54, Dylan Burpee. And number 40, Jack Jaynes, check into the defense again, trying to strengthen this line and see if they can hold him here on a fourth down. Fourth down, 6 yards to go. Quarterback's going to pass back. Uh-oh, he's got a man open. He's got a man open. And he just takes off with the ball. Another well-executed pass play by the Westford Gray Ghosts as they march about 52 yards on that play for the touchdown and go up 13-0 Westford. Damn. You off? I gotta get in. Okay, so Redding Westford comes up to the line of scrimmage. They're going to try for the extra try again. There's the snap. It's quarterback keeper. He's going to try to pass again. He's looking for somebody. No, he's going to tuck it down and keep it. As Redding's bopping all over the place, we got a flag on the play, folks. I don't know what that possible holding. He was no good. He didn't get in the end zone. So the attempt was no good. Just trying to see here what we've got for a flag. Usually have either a face mask on the defense or a hold on the offense in certain situations like this. And... well, do you happen to see what the... okay, Westford will kick off again to Redding. Again, back deep, number 7, Brendan Lindmark, number 3, Brandon Nowicki. And to help out in the return team, number 5, Quinn Dolan back there. And there's the kick. And it's directly to, looks like it was directly to number 80, Dylan Sweetser. But he did a great job in holding on to that ball as he was hit immediately after. So Redding will take over on downs. It's first down. They're going to have it at their own 48-yard line. Marching in, hopefully plug one in here before the half. Okay, first down for the Rockets. First and 10. As they come up to the line of scrimmage, quarterback is under center. There's the snap. The give is to... hard to tell who that was to. Wait till the pile peels off and see who's at the bottom. Number 7, Brendan Lindmark, was the ball carrier on that. Gets about a 2-yard gain. Number 40, Jack Janes, coming off. Get a breather. And we've got second down. Okay, let's see if Redding can get a first down out of this. They're exactly midfield. They've got 8 yards to go for a first down. It is second down. Quarterback is under center. Power eye formation. The give. Oh! The give is to number 7 again, Lindmark, but he was... the Westford defender was able to break through the hole there and wrap him up behind the line of scrimmage. It's going to be third down. Yeah. Okay. Number 42, Vendent Narayan, checks into the offensive line. He's playing tight end. It's third down, 9 yards to go. It's quarterback keeper. Eamon Centrella is going to keep it himself. He gets about 2 yards out of the play. Not enough for a first down. It's going to bring up a big fourth down here. Fourth down and about 7 yards to go. Redding is inside of Westford's territory, but, let's see what the coaches decide to do here. I'd like to... say thank you once again to the Redding Rocket cheerleading D-Squad cheerleaders out here to support the team, get the fans in the stands going, get Thrive a little life back into the squad. So thank you, girls. All right, so Redding. Now, the coaches have decided to kick it away. Iapika back for the kick. It's like number 70, Swanson, going to snap it. There it is. Good snap. Good kick. Oh, and it's going to get a great bounce. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Now, oh, all right. So the Westford receiver returner decides to jump on the ball, and he's downed at the 12-yard line. So with 2 minutes and 25 seconds left in the first half, the Rockets trail the Westford Junior Ghosts by 13, and... Westford now has the ball inside on their own territory at the 12-yard line, first and 10. All right, Westford comes up to the line of scrimmage. They've got big number 23, Michael Olson, playing nose tackle. Try to clog that line up. And Westford is going to take the ball in a QB sneak. He's got some room on the outside. Sweet just trying to chase him down. He makes a nice move. Beckenhouse is trying now. And they finally bring him down after an excellent run by Westford. Probably picked up, let's see, gosh, it had to be about 30 yards on that play, almost 30 yards on that play. Certainly enough for a first down as they will move the chains. So first and 10, Westford from their own 40. Westford comes up to the line of scrimmage. Quarterback is in the shotgun with two back set. He's going to drop back to pass. Ball is in the air. Oh, just overthrown. Nice attempt, but it falls incomplete for second down. All right, second down, 10 yards to go. Westford's at their own 40. Obviously trying to make something happen here. There's the quarterback snap. It's a double reverse. And it looked like Redding was fooled on that play as number 7, Brendan Lindmark, finally brings the ball carrier down after a nice pickup, though. Certainly a tricky little trickaroo play there. First down for Westford. And they brought the ball all the way down inside Rocket territory at their, looks to be 36-yard line. All right, first down for Westford as they come up to the line of scrimmage. Quarterback again in the shotgun. He's going to try to keep it himself, roll out. Number 50, Jason Anderson, made a nice play to get out there. But the Westford defender the Westford running back, QB, keeps running. He's going to stay in bounds, so the clock is going to continue to run. We're down inside of 2 minutes, about a minute 45 seconds left in the half, as Westford looks like they're going to go to a hurry-up and try to catch the Rockets offside again. But let's see. Let's see what happens here. Okay, they do. They're going to the hurry-up. And the quarterback is in. He's got the set. He's going to drop back. He's looking to pass it. Ball is in the air, but incomplete. And a great job by a Redding Rocket defender who came in there out of nowhere. It looks like it was Noah Roach, number 20. Great play. Noah Roach got in there and was able to put the pressure on the quarterback to make the ball fall incomplete. So we've got second down. All right. 10 yards to go for the first. It is second down. Quarterback's in the shotgun again. He's going to drop back. He's trying to pass it. Ball is in the air, and it is completed by the Westford Junior Ghosts as the receiver got behind the defensive backs for Redding and was able to get into the end zone for a touchdown. So another 6 points for the Westford Junior Ghosts. The score now 19-0. All right, so Westford on the extra try gets into the end zone. And with a minute 22 left in the first half, the Rockets now trail Westford by 20. So we've got a score, as I mentioned, 20-0 Westford, as the Rockets will come out and try to make a nice return on this kick. Okay. The Rockets are back to receive. Again, number 7, Lindmark. Number 3, Nowicki. The ball is kicked, and it's kicked to Nowicki, who's going to pick it up off the bounce. He's going to change direction, go back the other way. He's looking to cut up the middle. Nice running by Nowicki as he's finally met by the kickoff team for Westford as the Rockets will take over. First down. Okay, after the kickoff, the time expired in the first half. So at the end of the first half, the score remains 20-0 Westford. I think there were hopefully some adjustments here that coaches can make halftime. I'm sure they'll figure out a way to come back in second half action. And they will open up with the ball as they deferred in the first half. So Redding will get the ball when we come back in the second half. All right. Okay, as we open up second half action here, Westford will be kicking off to Redding. Second half, new half, new game as far as the Rockets are concerned. So the ball is kicked. Number 21 hits it. Number 3, Braden Nowicki, gets it, and he's brought down. It's important to note that number 32, Number 32, Michael Bartolini, and number 8, Rocco Mascherelli, are on the injury report, not playing today. So the Rockets are light two pretty good players. But as they take over on first down, they'll have the ball on their own 33-yard line, first and 10, as they come to the line of scrimmage. Quarterback, number 10, Eamon Santrella, is under center. And he's going to pitch the ball out to number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, who's unfortunately met behind the line of scrimmage as he tries to truck ahead. But again, unfortunately has nowhere to run on that. It's going to bring up second down, loss of about a half a yard on the play. Okay, the Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. And the second down, about 11 yards to go. In the power eye formation. The handoff is up the middle. He's got some room. Braden Nowicki crushes through the hole. He's on his horse. He's running. He's got it. And touchdown, Redding. What an outstanding play. Nice call, coaches. A little trap play. The give to Nowicki right up the middle. And he scrambles. Oh, God, that had to be about a 65-yard run as the Rockets get on the board. So, again, new half, new game for Redding as they put six up there and they'll try for the extra attempt. As the coaches bring the play into, call the play into the players. Santrella looking at the coaches, trying to figure out what to call here. He's going to lead his team. They break the huddle. These big linemen here ready to move that ball, get that ball carrier into the end zone, top off a nice play. Santrella under center. Is the give. He's going to try to keep it himself. And he gets in. Hey, all right. So the Rockets come out in the second half, breathe new life into the game. Must have got a great little pep talk there at halftime. So now we've got a score of 20-7. Westford still ahead, but a great play by Redding. Okay, number 6, Jack Iapica, ready to kick off. Get that thing deep down there. Nice kick. Oh! It's bounced a little bit down there. 3 Nowicki's down there again. As the Redding defender, we've got a flag on the play. And the Rockets finally bring him down. But as I mentioned, we've got a flag. Let's see what the call is here. Waiting for the referee's signal. Looks like we've got a hold. Against Westford, yes we do. It's a hold against Westford. So it's gonna back up the junior ghosts 10 yards, giving them a first down, 10 yards to go on their own 33-yard line. Westford breaks the huddle. They come up to the line of scrimmage. Don't worry about it. 21, both the center. They've got a two receiver set left, man in motion. There's the give. To the running back. He's got some room. Lindmark trying to chase him down. And he just can't get there in time as the Westford Junior Ghosts execute an offensive play for about 60 yards on the turf to get him down into the end zone. A great play by Westford. And they go up another 6 points. Here, so we've got 26-7 Westford as they try for the extra attempt. Great run. Okay, Westford's going to come up to the line of scrimmage for the extra point attempt. This time they go two receiver set right. Quarterback in the I formation. He's going to do the old trickaroo play as they are able to smash their way through the Redding defensive line and into the end zone for the extra point, making the score 27-7 Westford. Redding set to return the ball. as Westford gets ready to kick. And there's the boot. And it's a good kick. Right to number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, who's looking for some room. He's trying to scramble, but he might have got about a yard on the return. So the Rockets will set up in pretty decent territory here. They're on their own 40-yard line. First and 10, Redding. Okay, number 41, Sean Crowley checks in. Number 42, Vendin Narayan. Apologize if I said that incorrectly. Vendin Narayan checks in as well on the offensive line. See if they can help move this offense. Let's move this ball like we did last set of downs. And Centrella under center. He's going to give the ball up the middle to Lindmark, who gets about a yard on the play. There's a big scrum there in the middle. As the defensive offensive players peel off each other. And it's going to be second down, 9 yards to go. Number 54, Dylan Burpee comes in. He'll be playing your left tackle. Centrella under center. And he is wrapped up immediately. I'm not really sure what happened on that play. It looks like there might have been an exchange problem, or it may have been a problem with the exchange between Santrella and the center. But nonetheless, it's going to be third down and about 11 yards to go for the first. All right. Okay, Redding. Let's see if they can make something out of this here. They got a third and 11. They're under center again. There's a toss pitch to Lindmark. He's going to try to find some room, but he once again is met by a swarming Westford Junior Ghost defensive squad, and Coach Swanson's going to have to call on the punt team here. So Iapika got the responsibility of getting this ball down there and really getting some good field position here for the Rockets. So fourth and 10, and they're going to punt from their own 40-yard line. As they come up to the line of scrimmage, Giacomo ready to give him the signals that he's ready to kick it away. There's the snap and the kick. Almost blocked, but a good kick. The return man gets it as he cuts up, and he's running and finally brought down. Looks like back to the original line of scrimmage, so Westford will take over on the downs, first and 10. Okay, so Westford comes up to the line of scrimmage, and their standard shotgun set. There's the handoff. And great play by the Rocket defensive line. Trying to see who got his hand on him. Looks like it might have been number 72, Sean Murphy. But he was accompanied by a host of his other teammates there on the defensive line to wrap up the ball carrier. Second down, 10 to go. As Westford comes to the line of scrimmage. Back in their two receiver set. Quarterback, there's the give. He's trying to plow ahead, but again, Redding stops him. Got a few yards out of it, maybe two. But it's bringing up a big third down for the Redding Rockets. So let's see what they can do here. This is a big down, given the time and scoring everything in this game. So Westford comes up to the line of scrimmage. They're at the Rocket 38-yard line. They have 8 yards to get the first down. As Redding is looking to stop them here. There's the handoff. He's got a trap move. Nowicki's almost had him in the backfield. The defender is finally met. But he did run enough there for a first down, bringing the ball inside the Rocket 25-yard line, enough to move the chains. First down, Westford. First down, 10 yards to go. Number 23, Michael Olson playing nose guard. Number 80, Dylan Sweetser playing tackle. And what a great play by, who got in there? That was Donahue again. Of course it was. The big man on the line gets in there to stop the linebacker, stop the running back. Negative yards for second down. So Rockets come up big on that defensive play. Second down, about 13 to go. The camera. Number 22, Jordan Whitmer comes in. He's playing cornerback. He's going to help on the corner out there with this two-receiver set. There's the quarterback scrambling. He's looking now. He's going to tuck it and keep it. He's finally brought down by number five. Looks like Quinn Dolan on the stop. And it's going to bring up third down and about 4 yards to go for the Rockets. So number five, Dolan Quinn, and number 22, Jordan Whitmer on the tackle. To stop him for a big third. So we got a big third down, third and five. There's the trap play. And who else? Big Colin Donahue back there to make the stop behind the line of scrimmage to bring up a key fourth down. Okay, folks, here we go. Fourth down, 11 yards to go for Westford. They're at the Rocket 25. Quarterback rolls back. He's trying to find somebody to pass to. And he overthrows it. Nowicki on the coverage. So Rockets make great defensive effort there to get the turnover and stop Westford as they'll get the ball back. First and 10 from their own 25-yard line. Okay, folks, as we start the fourth quarter here, the Rockets trail Westford 27-7, but they do have the ball on their own 25-yard line, first and 10. Uh-oh, ball's on the ground, and it's picked up by number three, Braden Nowicki. Smart play by Braden. It looked like it was fumbled around down there. I don't know if that was a design play. And we do have, an injury, a man down on the field, so we have an injury timeout. Okay, Redding, fortunately for Westford, the injured player seems to be okay. And Redding takes the ball. They give it to, he's met directly. It was a hard run by Nowicki, I believe it was. He was running hard. And he's down on the field as well as we take an injury timeout. Okay, so number three, Braden Nowicki, after a good run and a good tough run there. He was knocked down, but he got back up, so he's okay. So it's going to be the quarterback, Aiden Santrella, keeps the ball. And he pushes ahead for a nice little gain there. He's probably got about 4 yards on the play. Looks like it was. And it's bringing up a big fourth down here. So we've got fourth down and about 3 yards to go for Redding. Looks like Coach Swanson's going to keep the offense on the field here and try to get a first down. So they need to get to the 35-yard line. Get that ball right across the 35-yard line for a first down. All right, here they come, the Redding Rockets. Looks like in a real big or tight formation jumbo, trying to get that extra 3 yards to keep the drive alive. Centrella, he's going to pitch it to Lindmark, who's trying to run ahead, but he finally gets popped at the line of scrimmage. And he's down on the field, but he's able to get up and shake it off. Unfortunately, it was not enough for the first down as Westford takes over. So good attempt by the Rockets. Good hard run by Lindmark, and Westford will take over. First and 10. Hopefully. Okay. First down. As Redding gets set to play defense. Westford with a little trap play. They're trying to get it. Anderson chasing him on the outside. And he's finally brought down by a combination of Anderson and Iapika for a gain of about 2 yards on the play for Westford. And it'll be second down, 8 yards to go. Second down, 8 yards to go for the Westford Junior Ghosts. Man in motion, the snap, there's the give. He's trying to get around the end. Leonard's trying to chase him down. Leonard does a great job of getting his hands on him to start hauling him down. He's finally assisted by Beckenhuis. But it's not enough to stop the first down as Westford moves the chains. And they will be first down inside the red zone at the 18-yard line for Redding. Thank you. All right, first down. 10 yards to go. Westford. Quarterback's going to keep the ball outside. He's got some room to the outside. He's scrambling. Beckenhuis trying to chase him. But that running back was just a little too fast for the Redding Rocket defense as he scampers into the end zone to put another 6 on the board. Great run. Great play by Westford. Got to give it to him. As they go up 33-7. Okay, Westford lines up for the extra attempt. They got the man in motion. Quarterback snap. Ball is down. And the refs are gonna call him down as his knee was on the ground when he tried to pick up the ball. So going into the fourth quarter, or rather we are in the fourth quarter with about 4 minutes and 30 seconds left to play in the game. The score, Westford 33, Redding 7. Okay, Westford's going to kick off to Redding back deep. Number 7, Lindmark, back deep. Number 21, Beckenhuis. And the kick is right to number 20, Noah Roach, who does a fine job of picking it up and running it back to about midfield, exactly midfield, where they'll get the ball. First and 10, Rockets. Hey. It's not looking here good here, Greg, as you can see. Field, they're going to try to get down here and punch another one in here before the end of the game. They've got the two receiver set wide. This quarterback is going to try to air it out, and he does. He gets it over to, nice pass by Centrella, getting it over to Beckenhuis, who plows ahead for, yes it is, folks, enough to move the chains. Great pitch and catch right there between Centrella and Beckenhuis for a first down, Rockets. Rockets come up to the field, line of scrimmage. They're at the Westford 40-yard line. It's going with the same two receiver set to the right. And the give is to number 7, Lindmark, who's got a little bit of room on the outside. And he gets nice blocking by the Redding Rocket offensive line and those receivers to give Lindmark about three and a half yards on the play. So second down and 6 to go. All right, Redding comes up to the line again. Got a little momentum going now, so see if they can keep it. And it's a trap play to Lindmark, who rushes ahead, bringing the pile with him. Nice little run, outstanding blocking by the offensive line to give him enough to to pick up the first down. Probably about a good 8 yards on that run, 9 yards on that run. First down, moving the chains, Reading. Rockets will get the ball. Rockets have the ball, rather, at Westford's 21. There's the pitch. It's back to Lindmark. He's trying to find some room around the outside. He shakes one blocker. He rushes ahead. Gets about a nice little scamper there for about a 3 yard gain. And we've got a timeout on the field. It looks like timeout Reading. Whenever you're ready. Reading comes up to the line of scrimmage on the ball. Going for the, looks like a quick snap, no huddle. As the coaches have them ready. And they're going to try to pass it out. The pass is to Beckenhues, who gets enough to, let's see, it might be enough to move the chains again. And they do. Excellent job. Excellent job. Another Centrella to Beckenhues. They're going to run the clock. They're going with the hurry up, no huddle. And Beckenhues is open again, and he scampers in. That's great play. Great play by the Reading Rockets as they found their sweet spot in Centrella to Beckenhues in the flat as he walks in for the touchdown. Nice job in shaking the defender. So right now we've got a score of 13-33. Westford still ahead as Reading will try it for the extra attempt. Okay, folks, so that last touchdown play there is going to end the game. Good way for the Rockets to go down there and score on the last drive. Unfortunately, they do fall short to a tough, tough Westford team. Got to give them a lot of credit. They played outstanding. So the Reading Rockets right now at the second game right now are unfortunately on the losing side, but we've got six more games to go. So I'm sure they'll find success in the others as we end our day here at Hollingsworth Field. And we will catch you next week as the Reading Rockets prepare to take on, I believe it's Chelmsford, but don't quote me on that. So enjoy your week, and thank you.